Hiya folks. A bit windy today. I don't know if you can hear any of the noise what I'm talking about, but me and Sharon are out walking Merlin at the moment, so we're just going to have a little walk along here. We've not been well, the pair of us, so we'll see you in a minute. So we found this little walking area where there's literally no dogs, no people, and Sharon's brought me along for the first time.
Merlin.
So he's getting really big now.
Come.
And he can be quite a handful, especially if he sees another dog, as I say. So we've brought him out to this quiet area, and just to try and get him out walking. He walks really well on the lead.
He does, he's very good.
What's that, baby?
He's very good. His only problem is when he sees another dog.
Yeah.
And it has actually put me off walking him, but I found his place now.
So she did start taking the lessons, and she went to one-to-one lesson, wasn't it, with a woman?
Yeah.
And that was £50.
55.
55.
£55.
In the field.
And she never really come back with any information what to do. So I told her to look online. There's got to be YouTube videos out there, so we're going to be probably looking at them.
I've had advice from somebody else, another dog trainer. Free advice.
Right.
And which I'm following. I just steer clear of other dogs at the moment.
Yeah, so on a lead, walking normally, he's fantastic. And also, he'll come and sit and stand and whatever, but I can't understand why. As soon as he sees another dog, he goes absolutely bananas. And that's something we can't have, obviously, because we want to be able to walk him. And that's the problem. So we're going to be going up to Stacey and Gary's very, very shortly. I'm going to be doing a little video, as you probably know quite a few of you. Where are you? Just out of shop, baby. We've done videos, me and Sharon, for the past 13 years on my home print channel, where we used to print t-shirts, mugs and all that lot, which we stopped doing about 2 to 3 years ago now.
Yeah, lovely.
Eh?
Lovely.
I thought it was a car. Yeah, so did I. I had a car.
A tractor, innit?
But we didn't stop it because the trade weren't there anymore. We stopped it because we'd had enough of it. It took over our dining room for the last 13 years sort of thing, you know? So Gary and Stacey have decided to start a little business doing the t-shirt printing. So we'll be going around to their house a little bit later and filming a beginner's guide to starting up your t-shirt printing business in 2021. So that's what we're going to be doing after this. We might take you along just to show you a little bit of that. But I will be doing a dedicated video for people wanting to try and start out. Both coughing away, yeah. Look.
And it's not what you think, people, it's just a
cold. We haven't got COVID.
We've all been tested.
You know, it's this time of year. I mean, I've not had nothing for 18 months. So this is the first thing I've had. And as I say, I've been bedridden.
But it's the changing weather.
Eh?
It's the changing weather. It's this time of year when you get cold and flu.
Well, the whole family's had it. Gary's kids have had it. Stacey's had it.
Even little baby Frank's had it.
Little baby Frank's had it as well. So.
Jimmy, Charlotte, everyone's had it. This is actually a nice walk.
Hey, baby.
This is a nice walk here. Nothing here, lovely.
Yeah.
No cars.
Yeah, little country lane. You get a lot of that out in the country, it's very nice.
See, when we go along across the river, you get the cyclists and you get other people, dogs. This, nothing, it's a back road.
Oh, cyclists, Sharon.
We don't like cyclists.
Well, it's not that we don't like them, Sharon.
Normal cyclists, it's your look, like crippled gauge.
If I go out on my scooter, right, listen to this. If I go out on my little scooter, and I didn't have a pair of gloves on, somebody in the comment section would say that you haven't got gloves on, health and safety, you should have a biker's jacket on, this, that, the other. Them cyclists, when they go out, they put on Lycra. Oh, hello, car behind.
After you said no cars.
They put on blinking Lycra. With shorts, with their knees on show, their elbows all exposed. All right, they wear a crash helmet. Bye.
What are you doing?
Oh, well, hold on, there's a dog in the bleak field, typical. You said there's no dogs here, Sharon.
I said to you back there, there's a dog in the field with a horse.
Do you want me to hold him?
Well, I want to try and persevere.
Come here.
Look, come.
See what I mean? Look how he goes, look. Lead, I've got it. Merlin.
Merlin, come.
Just let him look at it for a minute. Now there's a Rottweiler and a blinking stack in there. Look. Come here. Merlin.
Merlin, come.
Merlin. Merlin.
Come.
How'd you get over that one, folks?
Come.
She's got food, look.
Come.
He only wants to play with it, but this is what we get, you see. So any of you dog trainers out there, look, the food isn't working.
Come.
He's calming down now. Look, he can't sit anymore.
Come.
Look. There we go. You want to hold him, Sharon?
He's got all that round him.
Yeah, it's all right. So that, you know, you see it first hand there, folks. So anybody who's got dog training knowledge, how do you get over that? In a way, Sharon, I'm glad that happened now because they can see what the problem is. And for Sharon, he's a big dog. I can hold him. But you don't want to see a dog bounding away like that when you're out walking him, sort of thing, you know? Anyway. Yeah, so the old cyclists, they wear all this bloody Lycra stuff. No one has a go at them. And what gets me, especially when they ride two abreast, in their Lycra gear, as though they're on a blinking sporting event. Yeah? They're riding on the public highway, and they're stopping traffic. Now, I didn't realise that they were actually allowed to do that, ride next to each other. But they take full advantage of it, Sharon, when they've got all their gear on and they've got their heads down and their glasses on and their wind helmets. Now, in my way of thinking, should they be able to exercise their pastime on the public highway like that? Because if I got my skateboard out, Sharon, and started woof woof woofing up the blinking road on a B road or an A road.
But the thing is, isn't it?
Listen, would the police pull me over and stop me? Yeah, well, why? It's a wheeled vehicle, and I'm using it for recreational uses, just like they are. I'm not anti-cyclist, because I am a cyclist. I've got a bike. I've rode bikes all my life, so I'm not an anti-cyclist. But it's just these people who have watched telly, and they've seen these bloody cyclists on there, with all the Lycra on, and they feel they need to put it on when they're on the main road. Grow up, people. Some of it is a mature people.
Well, it's turned into a rant.
It has, isn't it?
Any suggestions on Merlin?
Yeah.
Please let us know.
Anyway, we're going to leave it there for a minute, folks. We'll see you when we get back to Gary and Stacey's, and I'll show you the equipment they've got for their new T-shirt business. I'll see you shortly. Right, so I've just made my way around to Gary's house now, and those of you who watch my Retro Restore channel will know that in the background is a shed we built nearly 7 years ago. And it's been many things. It's been a workshop. It's also been a hot tub room. It's then a workshop again, and it's now a workshop come print room. Let's have a look inside it. Right, so this is Project Man from YouTube. That's his workshop, and as you can see now, it's now kitted up for T-shirt vinyl printing. And I've done this, me and Sharon, for 13 years. So we know all about it, or we know a little bit about it, let's put it that way. And I've got many videos on YouTube and a dedicated channel for this. And as you can see, they've gone out and bought a second-hand heat press. This I actually use this Galaxy range myself, and it was a faultless when I had it. Cutter mat they got down there. They've got a starter set of vinyls there. Different T-shirt vinyls, different colours there, as you can see. So they've also got wall sticker vinyls up in the corner there, as you can see. So this is a nice little workshop area in here now. As I say, Gary's workshop, he had just along there. And although he probably uses my workshop more than this workshop, it's now converted into a T-shirt workshop. Dougal's out the back there running about. And you're in here, darling. Well, you're gonna be helping your mum make some T-shirts, are you? Hey?
Maybe.
So you know what this gear is. Remember all this stuff in Nanny and Grandad's house?
Yeah, because I remember doing some with you.
Yes, you've done some T-shirts with me. And so that's what your mum's going to be doing now. Daddy's not doing this, is he?
No.
He can't do it, can he?
No.
He can't even do this bit, can he?
No.
Anyway, let's have a little look. Oh, he's got a sticker board in here as well, look. A few of you know them YouTubers up there. But he's also got a sticker board down my neck of the woods as well. All the gear, look, have you ever heard the saying, all the gear, no idea? Anyway. So, coming inside.
Baby,
Dougal. Baby, you look like exhausted, didn't you?
I am, but it's Dougal's turn now.
Dougal's out, we've got Dougal now, haven't we? So So you like Dougal, didn't you, Evie? He's a soppy old thing, Dougal, isn't he?
Harry loves Dougal. Yeah. Harry wants to buy Dougal.
You like Dougal? Hey?
Dougal's not for sale.
He's gone quiet. I don't know what he's gone quiet for. He's normally chatty.
Merlin was for sale the other day.
Hey?
Merlin was for sale
Sharon,
the other
you
day.
Don't sell presents, baby.
Hello.
But it was a present.
Now, because he's changed. Thank
yeah.
God.
Hello. He loves that, doesn't he? Soppy Dougal.
Hello.
Anyway.
Dougal.
That's enough of that old toffee.
Kisses. Good boy.
So, I think we'll leave it here, folks. As I say, I'm going to teach Stacey how to use the Silhouette Cameo software now. And Sharon's going out with Dougal this time. I'm going to take the kid. You going out for a walk?
Yeah, the kid's coming.
They're going out for a walk, so I've got a bit of work to do. I've got a cold sore on my lip. I don't know what it is. It's a spot or something like that. That's only just come out this morning, Sharon, isn't it? Hey? We're falling apart, baby.
You should have seen my lip the other week.
Why?
Harry shot me with a Nerf bullet and my lip was...
He shot you with a Nerf gun?
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Brotherly love.
Brotherly love, yeah. Anyway, don't forget, folks, if you are interested in some merchandise or whatever, we'll set
you... Butler's Empire t-shirts or hoodies.
Butler's Empire t-shirts. And... Oh, yeah, you can print them, can't we?
Yeah.
We'll sort something out in the near future where we can get some merchandise and all that. Because, as I say, we were using other people, but now Stacey and Gary's going to be doing it. It'll be handy that we can print them off to order. You don't have to order big orders like ordering for a big company.
And pay the prices
Teespring charge. Yeah, that's right. Ridiculous. And their quality stuff isn't very good, shall?
No.
What we've had before. I've actually bought stuff off the Teespring before. In my opinion, that is, folks. Anyway, thanks very much, folks. We'll see you in the next video.
Hang on.
What?
Come on.
Oh, is he? I've got to bend down, shall I?
Here he is.
We'll see you next week. Don't forget, hit the subscribe button. And what they got to do?
Like,
cool. Just don't tell me, tell them. I can't hear you, darling. You've got to talk to the mics there, look.
Like, subscribe.
Yeah, that's it. That's all you got to do. That's all you got to do.
And share
a bit. Well, I don't think anyone ever shares videos, Sharon. Do they? Anyway.
Spread the love.
Anyway, we're going now, folks. We'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.
Bye,
come on, folks. Get the kettle on, Sharon.